So I have a question. Do you all normally get the Vroom internet package when you're on board or like right before your cruise? So you can kind of chat with people and things like that. Do you normally get that? I've gotten it a couple of times and I found it to be very expensive, but it just depends on what you're trying to do while you're on board the ship and who you're trying to communicate with. This is something we used while we were on board the ship that I've seen, but I never really thought about using before. Let me show it to you. Well, we paid $363.86 for the internet this time because I do a lot of vlogging and then he likes to stay connected as well. So the only thing that really saved us is because we had a $400 credit from a previous cruise that we didn't use, and they told us it had to be used on this cruise, and whatever we didn't use, we could not transfer it over to another cruise. So this is just a side note. If you have those future cruise credits, make sure you go ahead and use them because they will expire on you. So a good way to use them is to go ahead and book another cruise or to go ahead and use them as a part of your excursions or anything that you want that's aboard the ship. Now, I felt like this was pretty expensive. My mother did not purchase the internet package. She did want to use her phone, but let me show you that another way that we were able to keep in touch with her while we're on the boat, because basically she wanted to be able to keep in touch with us. You can use the landline phone in your room. It doesn't charge you to dial room to room. Now, if you're dialing out somewhere, it will charge. I'm not really sure of the fee for that, but it does charge. But if you're dialing room to room, it's absolutely free. You can also get a whiteboard. You have the whiteboard, you put the magnet on your door, stick the whiteboard up there, you can kind of leave messages for each other. Let me show you another way to communicate as well. Once you're aboard the ship, you can do this then. You're gonna click the little message button up on top, and then you're going to go ahead and click okay that you want to stay connected while you're on board the ship. So you stay connected and then click okay. Okay, your next step, I forgot to video this, so I'm just going to tell you. What you're going to have to do is you need to go and connect to the ship's Wi-Fi. You have to do this step. Connect to the ship's Wi-Fi and also place your phone in airplane mode. So it's just like when you're going on an airplane, when they say, hey, you make sure your phone is in airplane mode, same thing. You're doing that because you want to make sure that you're not going to be charged anything additional in order to use your phone while you're on your vacation. Now, this is just a way to communicate with other cruisers that are on board. This will not allow you to communicate with anyone that's at home, anyone that's on the island, when you're not on the island, things like that. It's only on board the ship. And it's $13.99, I believe. I know it was less than $15, and that's for the entire length of your cruise. So for me, it is definitely worth it. And let me just show you the next step so you'll see what it actually looks like. Now you will have to purchase this first, and I do stand corrected. I think it was $1.99 per day. So it just depends on how many days you're going to be on the ship. It was $1.99 per day, but it's per person that is involved in the chat. So $1.99 per day. So what you want to do is after you have purchased this, then you're going to go to invite to chat. Enter the person's full name, first name, last name, or however they are listed on their cruise documents. That's how it's going to come up. And make sure you click this next button that says let other guests find me by name. That's important because other guests will need to find you and they won't have nicknames or anything like that on there. And you cannot search for minors on here. So I think it's anyone that's under the age of 16 is what they consider a minor. You can link it by cruise reservation. So if you all book the cruise together and you know their reservation number, you can link it that way, and then you all will just be in the chat together. After you found the people that you want to chat with and add to the chat, then you can go ahead and click on their names once you find them, and you can still add more people. So it's unlimited. and you just go in and see my mom's name is first, and then so on and so forth. And what you want to do is, when you want to send a message, you're going to click the little box with a pencil in it. You're going to click that, click the person's name, and you're just going to write a message. So here's a good example. This is me chatting with my mom. There's one thing that's important to remember on this. Right under my mom's name, next to her initials, is going to say offline. Now, I did not realize that she had already turned her phone off, so the messages that I was sending to her weren't going through. So they would say delivered but not sent, or either vice versa. So we talked like the first day, good morning, breakfast at Windjammers. She sent that to me. She was being a little spicy. I was proud of her. She was able to do it on her own. It told her the time that it was sent, and then I put okay. So then I put, were the tickets in your room yesterday for the activities? So on and so forth. But notice how the top one said delivered at 9:36, and then the rest of them just say sent. At that point, her phone was actually turned off. She had turned it off because she wasn't sure if the chat was going to be charging her. So we just had to explain it to her when we saw her at breakfast. No, you can use the chat, and you can use your phone if you want to. You just, you know, we'll have some fees or something like that. She didn't talk enough to want to get the internet package because it is so expensive. As stated earlier in the video, this is just a chat. This is just a way to keep in touch with people that are on board. So you don't need the internet package or anything like that. It's a good way to just say, hey, we're going to meet up for lunch, or what excursion do you want to do? Things like that. Now, if you are someone that's trying to vlog or trying to get on social media, this is not going to be for you. You're going to have to pay for the expensive Wi-Fi package, because I'm being honest, it is expensive, because the chat won't allow you to do anything like that. Now, I can say this on Wonder, we had zero issues with the internet for the very first time of us purchasing the package. On all the other ships, when we've purchased the internet package, the room, we've had connectivity issues. You know, we would go down and, you know, make mention of it to guest services, but you know, they can only do so much. So I would say, if you're just chatting with others on board, or you know, sometimes I get up early, go to the solarium, my husband and I can kind of chat with each other, but this is just another way to do it for less, much less. All right, so if you use it, if you have used it and you didn't like it, or you did like it, put some of your opinions down below. Also, if you have any questions about it, you can put your questions down below and I will respond to them. Other than that, happy cruising.